Hey guys, this is Fraggle, and here we are playing Grand Theft Auto Online. Yeah, something different. So, this will be a quick tutorial on how I like to grind solo in this game. And see all these cars? This is what we'll be grinding. This is what we'll be finding because we can sell these cars for a pretty good price. So, ever since the game came out for free on Epic Games a week ago, in fact, today is the last day you can get it. I figured I should make this little quick tutorial and show you how I do my solo grinds. So, you don't have to be on a... See, I'm on a solo server, you can see on the top left. You don't have to be in any... You don't have to be in a public server, you don't have to be anywhere. It doesn't matter exactly. Actually, it's probably best if you are by yourself, or maybe with a friend, they can help you out too. Or you can help them out. So, the place we want to find these cars is... Okay, I'm down here. Is you'll find them down this street. And the path to find these is to go around... Okay, I come out... This is Tinsel Towers, and here's Eclipse Towers. I own both of them. If you own either of these or both of them, you can use them to keep the cars so you can sell them for later. Anyway, so the path I take is to go all the way around up the street and turn left. And as you turn left, you should see the car in front of you. Sometimes they don't spawn... Most of the time they do, and it does help to be riding in the car that you want to spawn, at least this version, any version, shut up.
Hello.
Shut up, Ms. Baker. To be in the Sentinels, these cars sell for a lot. The blue one with the pearlescent sells for $17,420, and the yellow one sells for slightly less. Trying to remember what it is. It's only, $14,970, but either way, they're both worth selling. But if you have the time, get the blue ones. That's why I have more blue ones. I have an empty spot here from their car. So what time is it now? Nope, not enough time yet. So I will show you how I do this, but the cars won't spawn because it's not the right time. The times they spawn in is between 2200 hours and 400 hours, or 10 p.m. to 4 a.m. at night. See, it's just now sunset, barely. So this is the path I usually take. It is very important you take this lane. At least try to get into it from here. But since there's usually a lot of traffic in the way, you can cut out here and go this way. After that, you should be fine. Go up the street. Here's the Eclipse Towers up here. And the car will usually spawn around here. Usually in this lane, like where this car is right now. Shut up! And you come back down around. And if you get one, then you can simply grab it and drive back either to Tinsel Towers here, or Eclipse Towers back there, which is behind that building. I would recommend, if you're starting out, to buy this one, because it's the cheapest one. This is the cheapest one out of the rest of them. But they're conveniently located. I think this one's only for the cheapest one. It's like $220,000. The other ones are above $400,000, something like that. I don't remember. I'll show them on the screen. So, we got another... Really, we have another couple hours. So here's the thing about this. You don't need to drive this car. I think I've said this already. You can drive any car. So if you're just starting out in the game and you don't have a Sentinel of any kind, it doesn't matter. In fact, I'll go ahead and just grab a random car and try doing it. Because early in the game, Simeon gives you the option to take any car you grab off the street and put insurance and a tracker on it. So if it's the right time of day, you'll take that bike.
Ooh, you look great.
Yeah, no one level. Nanner, nanner, nanner. Okay. Oop, free money. No. Free money.
Oh shit.
Oh yeah. Oh, now I got a one level. Shit. What time is it? Still too early. I'll probably cut here and get rid of this one level and then come back. All right, here we go. Hopefully we get a blue one. If it's the yellow one, I usually get a bother. But if you're starting out, you might want to grab the yellow one and make some quick cash. Nothing. I also think it might depend on the time of the day of the week it is. Right now it says Sunday if you look at the phone. I didn't get to see a lot of them on a like in the early days of the week. Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday. Weekends, I don't know. And sometimes by the time it gets to about midnight, they stop spawning for a little bit and then come back at about 2 a.m. Nothing, nothing, nothing. I'm not seeing Jack. Okay, I'm going to go ahead and get rid of this bike. It's usually, it tends to help if you actually have the car you want to spawn. Oh, sure. Now I find a BJ. That car. Hey, earlier I was playing, I was looking for one of those, and I couldn't find one. But now I find him, sure. That's how this game always works. All right, let's grab one of these. Often what I like to do is go in my garage, swap cars, and come back out when they're not spawning very much. That seems to help reset it. So since the, if you know that a second in the, or a minute in the game lasts 2 seconds in real life, so, since the hours is only 6 hours or something like that, what is it, from 10 to 4? Yeah, it's 6 hours? That's like 12 minutes in real time. Shut up. Here we go. Okay, here's a yellow one. But I don't want a yellow one. I'm going to get a blue one. Because they you get more money. 17,420. That was a yellow one. You might want to grab a yellow one. I use the yellow ones just so I can spawn the other ones. Or if you happen to find one out in the street. There's a blue one. Hey, buddy. Nice car.
I'm cool.
Oh, not fucking real.
Yeah, it is. Because it's a video game. It's not real. So the reason why these cars sell for so much is because they're modified. They're pre-modified. You can see, like, in the door, there's a roll cage, there's spoilers. The yellow ones have tinted windows and probably customized brakes and probably some engine upgrades and stuff like that. But it's the blue ones that have more, they're worth more because of the mods. And you got to remember, if there's a sale going on in-game that lasts a week, if any car modifications are on sale, then the sale value of these cars off the streets will be a little bit lower. Just keep that in mind. So let's see if we can get another blue one. And then I'm going to sell that one directly. And we got nothing. Well, no one got upset at me for driving on the wrong side of the road. Or the street. Hey, she likes my car. She always says that. Oh, I didn't hit that lane right. Hey. Stop turning left in front of me, even though I'm on the wrong side. I'm turning left in the right lane. Whoa, stop. No, it's not. It's worth like $2,500. Piece of shit car. This one's worth that one here. That's a baller. That's worth $9,000. Hey, there's one.
Jesus, I don't believe it. Jesus.
What? Hey, oh my God. What are you doing? No, no, no! Get!
You were real. Damn it!
Wreck my car, bitch! So you want to not damage it? So one of the good things about having a garage is if you do damage it, it doesn't matter because it'll get fixed after you put it in your garage. But if you're going to sell it directly off the street like I am right now, go away, bastard. Pink limo. When you get to the garage, you may have, well, you don't have to repair it. There's no point in repairing it if you're going to sell it. But this will sell.
What's wrong with her now?
Nothing's wrong with her. I just want your money. Give me your monies. Now, here's the thing. You notice my balance. Yeah, I'm $2.6 million. That's not a big deal. But you notice that will be in my pocket cash. If you sell a car that you had just gotten off the street, it'll become pocket cash. If you sell a car that's a personal vehicle, meaning not necessarily a car that you bought, but a car that you put into your... Ooh, I got money in my casino. Or not the casino, the nightclub. If you sell a car in your... out of your garage that you put in there, then it goes right to your bank. I also discovered that if you're in a CEO or a biker club and you're not the CEO or the captain of the club, and so and a subordinate does this and sells their car, the captain will look at the money, or the CEO will look at the money. It's really weird. So you gotta remember not to be in any group. You can be in a crew. Crew doesn't matter, but if you're in a motorcycle club or a VIP situation, you know, you're working for a Securo, which right now, I'm not even doing any of that stuff right now, am I? No. Anyway, so that's basically what I do, is I'll keep going and fill my garage until they're full. How much time we got left? Okay, we got a little bit more time left. Let's just grab a random car to see if we can find another one. Anyone get a bounty?
That's insane.
If I get a bounty, I'll just give it to my friend. They can shoot me in the head. Let's see if we can find one more. Yep, there's one right there. Oh, that's the yellow one. Never mind. How much time we got left? We have basically 2 minutes. No, we have 4 minutes. Hey! Thanks. Bastard! Of course, you're not turning left when you're going down that street. It's funny. Gotta turn the music off so they don't get copyright. Hey. Come on, give me a good car. Yellow one. I don't want a yellow one. Give me a blue one. So you can only sell these cars every 48 minutes because there's only... days only last 48 minutes. So street cars you can only sell once every day in the game, which kind of sucks, but hey, it's better than trying to sell any other cars because there's not that many other special cars like this that sell for that much. There is a special... Look, there's my actual car. Forgot it's still there. That's my car. There is a special Dominator, which is sort of like their version of a Mustang, that it's blue that spawns, and that sells for more than the... It sells for like 19,000 something. And I rarely find that. Usually you'll find that in the daytime, around 4 o'clock in the daytime, over here at the Los Santos Customs parking lot. Usually around here. I'll show you really quick. Yep, I can't turn. Derp! You'll find it here, right? In this spot, right here somewhere. In one of these parking spots. Usually it's one of these here. But only in the daytime, and it's rare that you'll find it. Sometimes I'll find this car, or the blue version of this car, the Sentinel XS. Will spawn there. I received 2,000 bucks for being a good behavior, whatever. Yeah, whatever. How much time we got? Oh, we got less than 2 minutes. That's maybe one more lap after this, unless I find it. Unless I get another yellow one. Whatever, go screw yourself. We're gonna keep on doing this until we can find a blue one. Or actually until the time runs out. Oh, there's a vanilla one. That's a vanilla Sentinel SX. I don't know how much they sell for. Not very much. We've got time. Because right at 4 o'clock, it won't be there. Blue, not blue. Be blue! Maybe do one more lap. As long as I don't crash into anything. Seconds. Damn it! Be blue! It's too late now. So, yeah, that's how you do it. If I can do it in 10 seconds. Gotta get in this lane. Always gotta be in this lane. It seems to help. Come on. Oh! Too late. It's not going to spawn. Get out here. Come on, get up. Get out of the car. Welcome to GTA. Maybe one did spawn. It's not. Nope, nothing. Oh, well, that's it. So that's how I do it. So, if you enjoyed this video, please click all the YouTuber things that YouTubers click on for YouTube videos that they like. And if you'd like to support me, you can send donations to my PayPal money bill. Links in the description. And if you'd like to support me, you can send, I totally screwed up that thing. You know what I always say. You can also send donations to my PayPal money pool or check out my wishlist for Steam and Amazon. So, thanks for watching. Be careful out there, and I'll see you.